Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to talk about the three types of in-app purchases. All right, so today I want to answer a question that came in a long time ago, way back on episode 266. This came from Pablo Perna. He said, "Hi Eric, thanks a lot for your videos. You're one of a kind. I'm a developer from Argentina and trying to run my business through in-app subscriptions on Android. Do you have any advice on this matter? Thanks." Man, I wish I did have advice. I wish I could say that I've done it and I was making loads of money from it, but I have never actually used subscription in-app purchases and I've never actually used consumable in-app purchases, although I've always wanted to. I just haven't ever got around to doing it. So all of the in-app purchases I've done so far have been non-consumable. And for those of you who don't know much about in-app purchases, some of you guys know all about them, so I'm sorry if this is not telling you anything new, but there are basically three types of in-app purchases. So, I mean, on Google Play, you got a choice of two, and on iTunes, you have a choice of four, but they're basically the same. You've got So on Google Play, you have managed in-app purchases or subscriptions, and on iTunes, you've got consumable, non-consumable subscription, a renewable subscription, and non-renewable subscription, right? So, but what it breaks down to is a managed in-app product on Google Play would be either a consumable or non-consumable, and consumable meaning that the user will use it up over time. So a good example of this is in-app currency. So if you have a user who goes through and buys like 100 coins in your game, as they go through and use those coins, they're consuming them and they'll need to buy them again later if they need another 100 coins. So your code actually has to tell Google Play or the App Store that you're using those up. So you have to keep in constant communication, or every time those are spent, you have to update them so they don't get restored, you know, later on another device and all that kind of stuff, right? And then non-consumable in-app products, which is what I do. All my in-app purchases have been non-consumable, which is like, you know, I really should have got around to doing some consumable ones, because it just seems like, you know, I think I just get giddy with excitement when I think people are actually spending in-app currency, but I've never actually done anything with it. So a non-consumable one would be, once they buy it, they have it forever. So an example is, I got an email just this morning from somebody saying they factory reset their phone. They bought one of the apps, Korean Heroes, through in-app purchase, and they reinstalled it, but they got the free version. What do? So I had to have a restore button. So I just told them where the restore button is. So for a non-consumable purchase, you pretty much have to have a way for them to restore those purchases if they've already made them. And in fact, the App Store, the Apple App Store, will not approve it. Actually, they shouldn't approve it if you don't have the restore button or some way to restore those purchases, right? So those are the two main ones are consumable and non-consumable. And then you also have the subscriptions. So yeah, subscriptions are stuff like, you know, it renews every year or every month or whatever, right? For me, the subscriptions that I've actually purchased in the past, again, I've never implemented this in any of my apps, nor have I implemented it in any client apps, at least not so far, right? So the ones I've actually purchased, though, would be like Runtastic and Headspace and that kind of stuff. And yeah, I don't know how well it works for them. So Pablo, I'm afraid I don't have really any advice to give you about which one of those you should choose. I guess you're going the subscription route, so I'd be really interested to find out how well that works for you, because I would love to go do something like that. And sometimes I've actually sat down and tried to make a list of things that I can make consumable within some of my stuff. I'm thinking, can we make it so, you know, you add extra coins and stuff like that? And I've just never got around to it. It's just when client work comes up sometimes, you think, I've drawn up designs with having, you know, purchase in-app currency, purchase coins, and then you spend the coins on levels rather than unlocking them through a non-consumable purchase, or you can, you know, gain the coins through playing and all that kind of stuff. So for people who don't have the money, but I've never actually implemented it, and it'd be really interested to find out how well you do with that. And also for anyone else out there who's using subscriptions or consumable in-app purchases, you know, and you're also using non-consumable, which one of those is working best for you? Do you find that your users prefer non-consumable purchases where they only have to make the purchase once, because as a user, that's kind of what I look for. And that's another one of the reasons why I haven't implemented the other ones, is just because as a user, I can't see myself making those purchases, and it's hard to implement that kind of stuff, you know, when you can't see yourself as a user, you know, at least in my opinion. So anyway, those are the three types of in-app purchases for those of you who are thinking about doing an app or thinking about monetizing in that way. The other way is sales. So just straight out purchase it. And you know, every single app that we've released has been a free version and a pro version. The free version has in-app purchases. To make it the pro version, it's a little bit more expensive if you get the free version first. But you know, we find that that has worked really well. I get a lot of purchases of the pro version, even though at one point I can remember consultants or you know, app gurus telling me, no, don't even do the paid version. Nobody buys the paid version, just do the in-app purchases. And people do buy the paid versions. So how is that working out for you? For those of you who are actually doing that, because I'd be really interested in knowing and just letting you guys know exactly where I stand. I've only done non-consumable in-app purchases, but one day. Anyway, that's it for today. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow.